Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon. I hope that you have learned something from my previous live video about the fear of public speaking. Ngayon, I want to tell you about the fears, the major categories of fears as described or as observed by Dr. Karl Albrecht. So this video is for the people who experience fear but cannot pinpoint what exactly scares them. Ganon. So, takot ka pero hindi mo alam kung ano ba talaga ang kinakatakutan mo. Ano yung exact fear or what kind of fear are you experiencing right now? Kasi pa pwede namang mababa or malaki talaga yung fear. However, you do not know what it truly is. So, this video is for you and I hope you've learned something from it. So, which brings me to my first point. So, the first fear, the first major category of fear is the fear of extinction. So this fear deals with the impending doom, immediate demise. So ikamamatay mo kagad. So pag hindi ka umalis sa kinakatayuan mo, pag tinamaan ka ng kidlat, patay ka kagad. That's the fear of extinction. Ayan. So yung mga triggers niyan is, yeah, fear of the dark, pwedeng fear of high places, flying, heights, yeah, fatal diseases. Yung alam mong, ano, yung alam mong mapupuksa ka pag na-encounter mo siya. So, yan. So, next, we'll move on to our second fear of mutilation or bodily invasion. So, pag sinabi natin mutilation, yan yung separation of your body part. So, kunwari, itong aking braso, nadaanan siya ng itak at naputol siya. Siyempre, nakakatakot yun. Because that it presents you with the permanent loss of your limbs. Hindi na siya may kakabit at hindi na siya tutubo. Hindi tayo parang butiki. So, yun. So, the fear of mutilation, dismemberment, yan. Yan yung mga triggers niyan. Bodily invasion primarily deals with foreign bodies getting into your body. Not necessarily exercising control, pero we can liken it to the pandemic right now. This is the major fear that everyone's been experiencing. Bodily invasion. So, foreign bodies like viruses, diseases, bacteria, or minsan yung irrational fear of being tracked through chips. So, that's the kind of fear that they're experiencing, yung bodily invasion. So, nakakatakot siya kasi you're experiencing something foreign infiltrating your body and you might lose control or it either eats you from the inside out, it causes you extreme pain, or you just lose yourself. So, yun. And third, we have the loss of autonomy. Loss of autonomy meaning nawawalan ka ng kalayaan. So, this is not just the physical, but there's also the mental aspect or emotional aspect of the loss of autonomy. So, this is the fear of being restricted, constrained, yung nakagapos, most common fear is claustrophobia, fear of tight spaces. It's not actually the tight spaces that makes it scary, but the fact that you cannot move and you cannot escape makes it all the more scary. Diba? So, that is the physical part. When it comes to the emotional or let's say the mental part, dyan na papasok yung ano, coach, kasama ba dyan yung ghosting? Yes, coach. Kasama dito yung ghosting. Kasi loss of autonomy or relationships, fear of relationships. Reaction na lang yung ghosting eh. So, yun ang mangyayari. So, you fear that when you commit to someone, you will lose your freedom, you will lose your privileges. Hindi mo na nagagawa yung mga dati mong gustong gawin. One type of trigger is poverty. Because you lose the freedom to exercise what you want. Like, gusto mo bumili, gusto mo bumiyahe. If you're poor, or if you're deep in poverty, hindi mo siya magagawa. Another is illness, especially if it's debilitating. Nakakatakot siya dahil magiging invalid ka or you'll be bedridden for the rest of your life. So, ayan, nakakatakot yung mga ganong klaseng ano. That deals with the loss of autonomy, third major fear. The fourth major fear is what most people truly dread. Ito talaga yung kinakatakutan, which is the fear of separation, abandonment, or rejection. So, if we're talking physical, if you get separated from a group, you may feel that you're helpless kasi walang tutulong sa'yo. Back then, when we were still tribal people and we still hunt and gather, separation from the tribe may mean death through predation, starvation, or through injury. So, if you translate it now sa panahon natin, this mostly concerns about relationships. Ayan. You fear that you will be separated from your loved ones. Ayan. Especially if may namatay, loss, yan. Inevitable separation yan. Or if you fear that you will be abandoned, so nagkaroon ka ng girlfriend o asawa, and they decide one day na hindi ka na nila mahal, so they leave. Or if you're just starting out, reaching out to people, for example, pursuing someone, then they don't like you. Hindi ka nila type. Then, hindi ka nila i-accept. So, yung fear of rejection. So, the fourth fear is mostly what eats us up in this era. Takot tayong iwan. And sometimes, trauma response para hindi iwan is to be extremely independent. So, ayan. Which brings us to our last major category of fear is the humiliation, shame, worthlessness, or collectively known as ego death. Dito, nagpo-fall under yung public speaking, yung kinakabahan ka. Okay? Ayan, kasi you may feel ashamed of going up at front. You might feel humiliated pag nagkamali ka nang sasabihin, pag bigla ka nag-stutter, or pag nakalimutan mo yung dapat mong gawin. Then, it progresses to the feelings of worthlessness kasi kasimple-simpleng bagay, hindi ko nagawa. So, this is the kind of fear that you usually see with people presenting themselves. So, the need to feel loved, the need to feel accepted, this is mostly directly inward sa atin. Ito yung nararamdaman natin. So, I hope that through the five categories of fear, sana ay na-classify nyo kung anong klaseng fear ang meron kayo. And that's the first step in knowing how to address it. So, knowing the problem is half the solution and the other half is taking action. So, I hope through this short video, you have learned something from me. And again, I am Coach TJ or Coach Jeriel, and I am a certified life coach from the Global Institute of Coaches and Entrepreneurs. And we have a headquarters in DCAP sa Pasig. If you want to visit us, feel free. And if you want to connect, you can connect with us through Coach Rizel at 0917-586-1661. So Coach Rizel, 0917-586-1661. So I hope you've learned something from me this afternoon, and I'll be looking forward to your comments and your feedback. So anytime you want to reach out, do reach out. We'll be here. Thank you very much and have a pleasant day ahead.